treatment.
Unfortunately, we've seen these shootings across the country. We had dreaded this day in this community, but we were prepared to handle these kids when they came here.
A day they dreaded and are now left to deal with the aftermath and attempt to figure out what went wrong.
Now to news of the islands and to the Big Island specifically. A community on edge tonight as lava creeps closer, less than a football field, in fact, from Apa'a Street. That has prompted Governor Abercrombie to sign a declaration asking for federal assistance. So far, no calls for evacuations, and for now, there's still a little time. Big Island Civil Defense tells us residents will still get at least 3 to 5 days' notice if they need to evacuate.
You know, we're asking everyone to, you know, be a little patient as we go through this change, because there's many more changes that may be coming as the flow continues in Maine.
Oliveira knows that's a difficult request. After two hurricanes and the continuing threat of lava, patience is a precious commodity on the Big Island. But the lava is coming, moving about 10 yards per hour. So Civil Defense will also keep on the move, going door to door in Pahoa tomorrow to make sure residents are ready.
It's also an opportunity for us to identify if there's any special issues out there, such as hazardous materials that might be on the ground that haven't been removed yet.
Oliveira says his team isn't ready to forecast a date when evacuations might be necessary, but he does say when the time comes, he wants residents to shut off their power and disconnect their gas lines. In the meantime, work continues on an emergency access route along the historic Chain of Craters Road that was overcome by lava itself decades ago.
Probably going to take between 45 and 60 days. After that, the surfaces will be laid, and hopefully we'll end up with a two-lane, 22-foot wide gravel road that people from Puna will be able to access.
And yet another concern on the Big Island, making sure utility poles are protected. And so Hawaiian Electric Light Company says crews have installed heat-resistant covers on the base of the poles near the lava flow.